معنى السلفية المفهوم الصحيح للإسلام المنهج الذي كان عليه السلف.
I would like to take a brief look at the firmness and the resolution and the certainty of one of the female companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is Summayyah bin Khubbab, the mother of Ammar.
Alhamdulillah alladhi arsala rasulahu bil huda wa din al haq liyudhhirahu 'ala ad-din kulli wa kafa billahi shahida. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما مزيدا أما بعد. My talk today is concerning following in the footsteps of the Sahabiyat, the female companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And no doubt this is a very beneficial topic and a very important topic, especially for the times that we live. Because we are living in a time where there are many trials and tests on a daily basis. But this is something that we should expect and not be surprised about, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. The people think that they will be left alone to say that we believe and that they will not be tested. وَلَقَدْ فَتَّنَّا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. And indeed we tried and tested those who came before them. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, what means, and certainly we tested those who came before them, and Allah will make it known, those who are truthful, and He will certainly make it known, those who are liars. With regards to the female companions and the companions in general, the Sahaba of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they are the best of generations. خَيْرَ النَّاسِ قَرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. The best generation, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is my generation, and then those who follow them, and then those who follow them. And there is a beautiful narration from ʿAbdillah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu an, which is authentic, that he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ نَظَرَ فِي قُلُوبِ الْعِبَادِ. Verily Allah looked at the hearts of the servants. فَوَجَدَ قَلْبَ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ خَيْرَ قُلُوبِ الْعِبَادِ. And he found that the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the best of hearts. فَاصْطَفَاهُ لِنَفْسِهِ. And he chose and selected Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for himself. فَابْتَعَثُوا بِرِسَالَتِهِ. And he sent him with his message. ثُمَّ نَظَرَ فِي قُلُوبِ الْعِبَادِ. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla, he looked at the hearts of the servants. بعد قلب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, after the heart of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, فوجد قلوب أصحابه خير قلوب العباد. And he found that the best of hearts after the heart of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم were the hearts of his companions. So the companions, they possessed the best of hearts after the heart of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم from this ummah. Therefore, there is no doubt that the companions are the best of generations, and they are an example to be followed and to be imitated due to their faith, due to their righteous actions, due to their impeccable character, due to their sacrifice, due to their struggles, and many other virtues. The believer is going to be tested in this life. A person may be tested with lusts and desires, or a person may be tested with doubts. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi and others, he was asked, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, Ayyun nas ashaddu bala'an, who are the people that will be tried and tested the most? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Al-Anbiya, the prophets, they will be tested the most. ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلْ فَالْأَمْثَلْ, and then those who imitate them the most. And then those who imitate them the most. يُبْتَلَ الرَّجُلْ عَلَى حَسْبِ دِينِ, a person will be tested and tried according to their religion. So any test that we experience in life, if we fear Allah Azza wa Jalla and implement the Quran and the Sunnah and follow in the footsteps of the companions, we will be able to get over it. لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وَسْعَهَا, Allah does not burden a soul with more than it can bear. Any trial in life, yes, we can get over it if we fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزَقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ, whoever fears Allah, Allah will provide for them a way out. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, يُبْتَلَ الرَّجُلْ عَلَى حَسْبِ دِينِ, a person will be tested and tried according to their religion. فَإِنْ كَانَ فِي دِينِهِ صُلْبًا اشْتَدَّ بَلَاءُهُ, if a person is strong in their religion, then the test, it will be more severe. وَإِنْ كَانَ فِي دِينِهِ رِقَّةً اُبْتُلِيَ عَلَى قَدْرِ دِينِهِ, and if a person has a weakness in their religion, then they will be tested according to their religion. فَمَا يَبْرَحُ الْبَلَى بِالْعَبْدِ حَتَّى يَتْرُكُهُ يَمْشِي عَلَى الْأَرْضِ وَمَا عَلَيْهِ خَطِيئًا, and the servant shall be tested continuously and tried until he is left walking the earth without any sins, if that servant was to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla as Allah deserves to be feared. I would like to talk briefly, because this lesson here, this lecture here, is for the women. I would like to choose one of the female companions. I would like to take a brief look at the firmness and the resolution and the certainty of one of the female companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is Summayyah bin Khubbab, the mother of Ammar. Summayyah bin Khubbab, the mother of Ammar radiallahu anhum ajma'een, and this is a woman from the women of paradise. This is a woman from the women of paradise. This is a woman who remained firm and resolute. This is a woman who loved Allah Azza wa Jalla and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything else, even more than her own well-being. This was a woman that did not worry about this world, rather she worried about attaining the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jalla and eternal bliss in paradise in the Akhirah. As for us living in this time, then our tests and our trials do not compare to what we will hear as it relates to the tests and the trials that the companions experienced, and alhamdulillah they conquered and they were able by the tawfiq of Allah Azza wa Jal to get over, to get past. As it relates to Summayyah bin Khubbab, Summayyah the daughter of Khubbab radiallahu anha, then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, qala kana awwala man adhara islamu sab'a, the first to profess the Islam was seven. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa Abu Bakr, the second Abu Bakr, and Ammar, wa Ummuhu, and his mother Sumayyah, wa Suhayb, wa Bilal, wa Miqdad. فَأَمَّا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ بْنُ مَسْعُودٍ he said رضي الله عنه he said as for the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم فَمَنَعَهُ اللَّهُ بِعَمِّهِ أَبِي طَالِبٍ then Allah عز وجل تبارك وتعالى protected the messenger of Allah through his paternal uncle Abu Talib وَأَمَّا أَبُو بَكَرَ فَمَنَعَهُ بِقَوْمِهِ as for Abu Bakr فَمَنَعَهُ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمِهِ then Allah عز وجل protected Abu Bakr through his tribe, his people, his clan. وَأَمَّا سَائِرُهُمْ as for the rest of them, those who did not have any clan, those who did not have anyone to protect them. And this, no doubt, is something that we find in the world. That the tyrants, they would focus upon the weak. As for those, the rest of them, أَمَّا سَائِرُهُمْ فَأَخَذَهُمَ الْمُشْرِكُونَ وَأَلْبَسُوهُمْ أَدْرَاءَ الْحَدِيدِ وَسَهَرُوهُمْ فِي الشَّمْسِ The rest of them, the polytheists, would persecute them and torture them and make them wear armor made of metal and place them in the intense heat of the sun. To be burned by the sun, wal-iyadu billah. Imagine that. They did not differentiate between the young and the old, the male or the female. And Sumayyah bin Khubbab radiallahu anha, the mother of Ammar, she was amongst them. Imagine that as a mother. Imagine that as a wife. That before you, your husband is being persecuted and tortured and being exposed to the baking heat of the sun. In armor made of metal. Imagine as a mother seeing your child being tortured and persecuted before you because of La ilaha illallah, because of the testimony of faith. None has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah, alone without any partners. And because they abandoned all forms of shirk, polytheism, and idol worship. Imagine that. But Sumayyah, radiallahu anha, Ammar, the mother of Ammar, she had certainty, yaqeen, certainty that allowed her to get over these trials and these tests. As Allah عز وجل said تبارك وتعالى إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون The believers, those who have complete faith from them Sumayya رضي الله عنها Ammar, the mother of Ammar The believers are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and after that they have no doubt, they are not shaken. They are not shaken. They are firm, they are resolute regardless of what trial and test is placed in front of them. Because as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a person is only tested and trialed according to the strength of their religion. The believers with complete faith, they are those who believe in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then they have no doubt. And they strive with their own selves and they strive with their wealth in the cause of Allah and they are the truthful. They are the truthful. Naam. They are the truthful. They are the truthful in their speech. They are the truthful in their actions. They are the truthful in their intentions. They are the truthful. Sumayya radiallahu anha, Ammar, the mother of Ammar. This woman from the women of paradise. هذه المرأة من نساء الجنة, from the women of Jannah. That comes in the hadith, Hasan wa Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah, Shaykh al-Albani declared to be sound. Marra bihim al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed by. Ammar, the son of Summayyah bin Khubbat, and the husband Yasir. And the three of them, they were being tortured by the mushrikun, the polytheists, the idol worshippers. Being tortured, why were they being tortured? They didn't commit any crime. They didn't do anything wrong. Their only sin was what? That they said Allah is our Lord. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And then they were firm and they were upright upon that. Their only crime was that they abandoned the worship of the false deities. And they singled out Allah Azza wa Jal with all worship. Their only crime was that they believed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they followed him. And they adhered to his sunnah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed by the three of them, the mother, the child, and the father, and they were being tortured. يُعَذَّبُونَ. So upon seeing that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, صَبْرًا عَلَى يَاسِرٍ. Be patient, O family of Yasir, who was the husband of Sumayyah bin Khubbat, the father, na'am, the mother, and the son, being punished and tormented. فَإِنَّ مَوْعِدَكُمْ الْجَنَّةِ. As indeed, your promise is paradise. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, offering these words at such a difficult time. But look at the certainty of this woman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, صَبْرًا عَلَى يَاسِرٍ. Be patient, O family of Yasir, for indeed, your promise is paradise. And she was patient, sabarat, for the sake of Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, desiring what is with Allah. Mujahid, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, concerning Summayyah, he said, awwalu shaheed, the first martyr in Islam, was the mother of Ammar, meaning Summayyah bin Khubbar, radiallahu anha, طعنها أبو جهل. أبو جهل, that tyrant, الملحد الكافر, المشرك, that polytheist, that tyrant, طعنها, he stabbed Sumayyah رضي الله عنها with a spear in her private area. What a coward. And she was the first martyr in al-Islam. Look at this example, a woman who is more courageous than many men because she stood firm for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal in what she believed. And she understood that if she was patient, then this is the way to paradise. And in our time, us as individuals, how many tests do we experience in life? And they are a lot easier than the test that we just heard about, that Summayyah radiallahu anha, Summayyah bin Khubbab experienced. And how many of us have the certainty, how many of us have the faith, how many of us have the courage to fear Allah Azza wa Jal and to remain firm so that we can truly get over it and please Allah Azza wa Jal tabarak wa ta'ala in the process. How many of us? One of the trials and the tests in this time in social media with regards to Instagram and Facebook, how many people can even overcome the test and the trials of social media? Not exposing their sins, not using these forums to disobey Allah Azza wa Jal. And other than that, things which in reality are simple for the one whom Allah Azza wa Jal makes it easy for. As nothing is difficult unless Allah Azza wa Jal makes it difficult. So when we read the like of this biography of this woman, let us take many benefits from it. And let us recognize and understand that life is a test. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. Allah created life and death to test you, to see who is best in action. We're going to be tested. Because Allah will make it known who is truthful. And Allah will make it known the one who is not truthful. If we say we believe in Allah, if we say we believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we say we believe in Islam, if we say we are pleased with Allah, if we say we are pleased with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our prophet, if we say that we are pleased with Islam as our religion, then yes, we should be firm upon it, and we should be willing to struggle and sacrifice in order to spread it, and we should be willing to suffer and sacrifice in order to remain firm upon it. Imitating the female companions, and specifically the one that we spoke about today, the woman from the women, one of the women of paradise, Summayyah bin Khubbab radiallahu anha. And I will suffice with that. And ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to benefit us all from what we have heard, and to allow us to imitate the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For indeed the latter part of this ummah, the latter part of this ummah will not be rectified, will not achieve success, will not prosper, will not taste certainty and victory, except with that which rectified the first part of it. وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.